welcome to Monmouth in Focus, a program about the services and functions of Monmouth County government. I'm Cynthia Scott, your host for this segment of Monmouth in Focus. Today we are joined by Monmouth County Clerk Christine Hanlon. Thanks so much for joining us, Christine.
Thank you, Cynthia.
We are talking about passports, a very important issue, lots to cover today, and your office can certainly help.
Yes, that's right, Cynthia. Many people don't realize that the County Clerk's office is authorized by law to assist people with passport application.
Where do residents apply and what's the process?
Well, the process of issuing passports is handled by the federal government, mm-hmm. but our office is authorized to assist with the process. Okay. So we like to encourage people all the time to make sure that their passport is up to date. If they're going to be traveling in the future, it's very important to be prepared with your passport or to renew your passport if it's set to expire. So we actually have three different locations that is run by the County Clerk's office where people can come and get assistance with their passport applications.
Mm-hmm. And one location we know is in Freehold. That's where the main office is, correct?
Correct. We have our main office in Freehold, which is at 33 Mechanic Street. And we're open every day from 8:30 to 4, Monday through Friday. And then we actually have another location in Neptune at 3544 Highway 66. Mm-hmm. It's in a strip mall right next to the Home Depot on Route 66. And the nice thing about that location is that we have evening hours and we also have Saturday hours. So for people who can't get to an office during the day because of work or some other reason, we now have evening hours and Saturday hours. So we try to accommodate people's schedules.
Yeah, which is really important too, because like you said, you know, people work all day and then by the time they get to you, it's closed. So that's real important. I remember a few years ago when it opened, way back when, a lot of people were enthusiastic about it. I'm sure it's busy there.
Yes, we're very busy. The County Clerk's office processes over 10,000 passport applications a year. Mm-hmm. In 2017, we're already on track to exceed that number because wow. We've been very, very busy. And that is actually one of the reasons why we opened an additional satellite office that we're really excited about. And that is at the Monmouth Mall. And we're open there the first Thursday of every month. And it is open from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. And we're actually there with the Monmouth County Sheriff's Office and the Monmouth County Surrogate's Office in an effort to bring our services out to the community. Mm-hmm. So now that has become another passport hub, the first Thursday of the month, and people can come there and get their passport photographs taken.
That's
and
great.
They can get help with processing their passport applications.
That's great. Now you talk about applications. What exactly does someone have to do to apply for a passport?
Well, I will say that it's very important if you wanna make sure you have all the right documents to call our office ahead of time so that you don't make the trip and come down and then you know realize that you don't
right.
have the right information.
Sure.
But generally, people need a birth certificate with a raised seal. A lot of people come in and they don't have the raised seal on their birth certificate, so then they have to go back to the town where they were born to get the certificate with a raised seal. That's very important.
Okay.
You also need a piece of identification that has a signature on it, and there are various forms of ID that are taken, which you can find on the federal government's website, mm-hmm. and it's travel.state.gov. You can also find it on our website, visitmonmouth.com/countyclerk, because there's only certain types of ID that are accepted.
Okay.
In addition to that, you need a passport photo, and you also need a social security number. So those are the four main things that you need. Now, if you don't have a passport photo, we try to make things convenient for our residents. And we now do passport photos in our office, in all of our locations.
Great.
So we can take the passport photo when you come to our office for
okay.
assistance.
Instead of them going to, let's say, a CVS and having to get them
correct.
There and then making another stop. So, oh, that's great. So
right.
it's kind of one-stop shop at the clerk's office.
Yes, and the nice thing about taking the photograph in our office is that because we are passport agents, we can make sure that the photograph is
perfect.
the right photograph,
yeah,
and it's
right.
You know, has the right lighting, and you know, the federal government is very strict about the passport photograph, and that's actually something very interesting to talk about right now. The federal government has issued a new directive that people who take passport photos cannot wear glasses in the picture. So that's a new directive that just came out. People have to be very careful about not taking their passport photograph with glasses on.
Okay, right, so that's great, because if somebody just says, oh, I need to take some photos passport size at a pharmacy or something, they may not realize that.
Correct. So when they do it with us and they come take their photograph in our office, we make sure that all the boxes are checked and you know, we're compliant
right.
with the federal regulations.
That's great. Yeah. And anything else that you need to know rule-wise when it comes to getting your passport?
Well, it's important to know how much time it's going to take to actually get your passport. Because of the high volume of people who are getting passports and all the new regulations about travel, the Federal Passport Agency is very busy, and it takes several weeks to, you know, from the time you submit your application mm-hmm. until the time you get your passport. Mm-hmm. So what the federal government is saying right now is that it takes 6 to 8 weeks for a regular passport process. Now, you can do expedited, of course it costs more, and that the estimated time is 3 weeks.
Okay.
Now, I've found that oftentimes people will receive their passports in a shorter period of time,
right.
but you have to at least allow for the 6 to 8 weeks.
Sure.
So if you have a trip coming up, you have to make sure that you give yourself enough time so that you can get your passport back
yes.
in time, because you will not be able to travel to many, many places without your passport.
And is that for, does everyone need a passport? Infants, I mean, 2 year old?
Yes.
Okay.
Children need passports, mm-hmm. And that's some rules. There are some special rules about getting passports mm-hmm. for children. When you want to get a passport for a child, both parents have to be present. So if you came in and, you know, one parent is at work or, you know, unavailable, you can't even complete the application. Mm. Both parents have to be present, and everyone needs a passport, you know, depending upon where you go.
Mm-hmm. So parents have to be present for children under 16, correct? Both parents have to be present
correct.
For, okay.
Yeah.
So also, would you recommend getting your passport renewed before it expired? Can you do that?
Yes, you actually should do that, because there are many countries that require your passport to be valid 6 months after your travel date. So mm-hmm. many people don't realize that, and then they are denied entry. So you have to really check your passport if you're going and make sure that your passport is valid for a good amount of time, or check which countries require that your passport is valid
right.
you know, for more
right.
than 6
correct.
Months after.
Yeah, then you can...
So it's really important to do your research, because I can't tell you how many stories I hear of people who are, you know, about to travel, you know, the next week or the next day, and they realize, "Oh my gosh, I didn't realize that my passport was going to expire, or that oh, I even needed a passport
sure.
to go."
Yeah.
So it's very important to check out
it.
these things.
And people yeah. don't think about it until they absolutely have to.
Correct.
You know?
It's important to think about, if you're a traveler, you know, to make sure that you have all of your documents ready. And one thing I do recommend to travelers is to always check the federal Secretary of State uh-huh. Guidelines. Mm-hmm. Because there are things changing all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And you may not realize that some particular regulation has changed
right.
and now you're not in compliance.
Right. Absolutely.
So there's some really great information on our website, visit monmouth.com/countyclerk, and also on travel.state.gov is
okay.
the Federal Passport Agency website. And they have all of the travel alerts.
Okay.
There are new travel alerts that are issued, you know, on a daily basis.
Absolutely.
It's important to know if you're going to a country that has had a recent travel alert.
Mm-hmm.
So you always want to be researching before you go places, because there could be something new that occurred,
mm-hmm.
whether it's a terrorism travel alert, or maybe a specific contagious disease travel alert, you want to be aware so that you can protect yourself and make sure that, you know, you have the information you need and all of the documents that you need to actually travel to some of these places.
Yeah, great advice there, Christine. Also, so for adults, our passports are good for how long?
They're good for 10 years.
Okay.
Yes, so, but, you know, it's always good to check to make sure that you haven't miscalculated your years when you're getting ready to travel.
And then children?
Children is 5 years.
Children are 5 years, okay.
Yes.
Okay, so.
So I recently had a situation with, you know, a person who called and said, oh my gosh, I didn't realize that, you know, my child's passport had expired, but ours as the parents had not. And they had gotten into a situation where they had to cancel their plans and rebook their trip for another time because they just couldn't go.
You just, like we said, you put your passport in your drawer, you don't really think about it until you book that trip.
Correct.
And then maybe a couple of weeks before and it's too late. So yeah, you really have to be conscious of that. So thank you for providing us with that great information. And of course, again, www.visitmonmouth.com for passport information or any more information about the Monmouth County Clerk. Christine, thanks so much for joining us today with some really useful information out there. I'm Cynthia Scott. Have a great day, everyone.